Law of conservation of momentum. Using wiring channels of 1.5 meter length and 4 marbles, perform the following activities as shown in the figure. Move the first marble slightly back and roll it forward. What happens? The marble moves forward and comes back to the original position. So if one of the ball is moved backwards and released, what will happen? Yes, the ball from this end goes forward and again it comes back to its original position. Then second question, bring the two marbles together and let them roll. What happens? So now the two marbles from the other end moves to the upper side. So if we release one ball here, then one ball from this side will go upward, and if we release two balls simultaneously from here, then what will happen? Two balls from here will go upwards. What is your inference? When an object collides with another, the total momentum of the objects will remain unchanged. So what happens when an object collides with another, the total momentum of the objects remains unchanged. That is, the total momentum before the collision is equal to total momentum after the collision. Let's verify it by applying Newton's third law of motion. Consider two bodies A and B of identical size but having different masses m1 and m2, moving with velocities u1 and u2 in the same direction in a straight line. If A moves with greater velocity, it will bump on to B. After collision, if their velocities are changed to v1 and v2 respectively, let us find out the total momentum of the system. So according to Newton's third law of motion, F12 is equal to minus F21. Then total momentum before collision. So what is the total momentum before collision? Yes, total momentum before collision is M1 U1 plus M2 U2. So the momentum of the object A plus the momentum of object B before collision. So initial momentum or the momentum before collision is m1 u1 plus m2 u2. After collision, the momentum after collision is m1 v1 plus m2 v2. The forces acting on the two objects at the time of collision can be found out by the second law of motion. What is the initial momentum of A? So the initial momentum of A is m1 u1. Then what is the final momentum of A? The final momentum of A is m1 v1. What is the change in the momentum of A? So change in momentum of A is m1 v1 minus m1 u1. So this is the change in the momentum of A. Then the rate of change of momentum A is equal to m1 v1 minus m1 u1 divided by t. Let us find out equations for the above in the case of B. The initial momentum of B. So what is the initial momentum of B? m2 u2. Final momentum of B is m2 v2. And change in momentum of B is m2 v2 minus m2 u2. And rate of change of momentum of B is m2 v2 minus m2 u2 divided by t. According to the second law of motion, rate of change of momentum is directly proportional to the external force. Then how will you find out the force exerted by B on A and the force exerted by A on B? That is, FAB is equal to m1 v1 minus m1 u1 divided by t. So according to second law of motion, force is equal to m1 v1 minus m1 u1 divided by t. Then FBA is equal to M2V2 minus M2U2 divided by T. According to the third law of motion, we can write force acting on A by B is equal to force acting on B by A. That is FAB is equal to minus FBA. Then using second law, Newton's second law of motion, we can write M1V1 minus M1U1 divided by T is equal to minus M2V2 minus M2U2 divided by T. So here TT, on cancelling this TT, T and T, we will get M1V1 minus M1U1 is equal to minus M2V2 minus M2U2. So opening the brackets and rearranging, we will get M1V1 plus M2V2 is equal to M1U1 plus M2U2. That is, the total momentum after collision is equal to total momentum before collision. So in the absence of an external force, the total momentum of a system is constant. This is the law of conservation of momentum. So what is law of conservation of momentum? Yes, in the absence of an external force, the total momentum of a system is a constant, and this is called law of conservation of momentum. Two questions are given in your textbook. A bullet is fired with a velocity V from a gun of mass M. What will be the recoil velocity of the gun if the mass of the bullet is M? So a bullet is fired with a velocity of V from the gun of mass M. So capital letter M is a mass of the gun, and small letter m is the mass of the bullet, and small letter v is the velocity of the bullet, and capital letter v is the recoil velocity of the gun. So here in this question, we have to find out the recoil. We have to find out an expression for the recoil velocity of the gun. So how can we find this? Yes, according to law of conservation of momentum, we already studied that total momentum of the gun and the bullet before firing and their total momentum after firing will be equal. So according to law of conservation of momentum, the total momentum before firing is equal to total momentum after firing. So what is the total momentum before firing? See, before firing, both gun as well as this bullet are in the state of rest. So the velocity is zero. Therefore, momentum is also zero. So total momentum before firing is zero. Then what about after firing? Yes. So after firing, the momentum of bullet is small letter m into small letter v. That is mv. And the momentum of gun is capital letter M into capital letter V. That is MV plus MV. According to law of conservation of momentum, we can equate these two equations. That is, total momentum before firing is equal to total momentum after firing. That is, 0 is equal to MV plus MV. So bringing this MV, bringing this MV towards this side, it will become MV is equal to minus MV. So on bringing this small letter, the momentum of the bullet to this side, the equation will become MV is equal to minus MV. From this we can write the recoil velocity of the gun is equal to minus mv divided by m. So this is the equation for recoil velocity of gun. The recoil velocity of the gun B is equal to minus mv by m. The negative sign indicates that gun moves in the opposite direction of motion of the bullet. So here negative sign indicates that the gun moves in the opposite direction of the motion of the bullet. Suppose bullet moves in this direction, then the gun moves in in this direction or gun recoils in this direction. Next question. Suppose a child of mass 40 kg running on a horizontal surface with a velocity of 5 meter per second jumps on a stationary skating board of mass 3 kilogram while running as shown in the figure. If there is no other force acting horizontally, assuming the frictional force on the wheels to be zero, calculate the velocity of the combined system of the child and skating board. So here the mass of the child is 40 kilogram and this child is moving with the velocity 5 meter per second, and here is the skating board which is at rest, and the weight of this or the mass of this skating board is 3 kilogram. So here we have to find out the velocity of the combined system of child and skating board. So here we have to find the combined velocity of child as well as this skating board. So how can we find this? Yes, here also we have to use the law of conservation of momentum, that is the total momentum of the child and skating board before jumping will be is equal to, so what is the momentum of child? Yes, momentum of child is mass of child into velocity. So mass is 40 kilogram into velocity is 5 meter per second plus mass of the skating board is 3 kilogram, and since it is at rest, so velocity is 0. Therefore, the total momentum of the child is 200 kilogram meter per second. So this is the total momentum of the child before jumping. Then total momentum when the system starts moving. So while jumping on this skating board, what happens? This skating board moves in this direction. So the total momentum when the system starts moving, boy and skating board starts moving. So at that condition, what is the momentum? So here we have to find out the combined momentum, that is the momentum of boy and skating board. So in this condition, the total mass of this system is mass of the child plus mass of this skating board, that is 40 plus 3 kilogram into u is the combined velocity, that is velocity of child as well as velocity of skating board. So total momentum is mass into velocity. So mass is 40 plus 3 into velocity, that is 43 into u kilogram meter per second. According to the law of conservation of momentum, total momentum remains constant, that is we can equate 43 into u is equal to 200 kilogram meter per second. So on equating and simplifying, we will get u is equal to 4.65 meter per second, that is the velocity of child as well as the skating board is how much? 4.65 meter per second. So this is the combined velocity.